date is October 2nd, 2011. The time is 21:15. Ma'am.
No, he's been here for a while.
He's
here for like 2 hours already.
More than Barbie's.
How long have you been here for?
2 hours.
Yeah, around 2 hours. Yeah. Have you seen
the message?
Did you pass out? Was consciousness?
No.
Is there a story to come out here and stand by on this? He's in the office.
You're talking all the time. You did not pass out.
Yeah. You didn't pass out.
Thank you for your release consciousness. Okay, so don't try to tell me you did.
Do you want to hold that so you can wipe some more?
No.
That was a real threat to
him.
You guys do whatever you want. You guys kill him already. Make it easier.
Not yet, not
working.
That's
some water.
That's not water.
You don't want to drink that.
Yeah,
you don't
want to drink that.
Whoever it is, you're a fucking asshole.
I mean, I don't know.
I'm ready. Don't put your wig in here.
Man with a gun, you fucker.
Is there a medical problem, sir?
Depression, anxiety, and psychological.
What medication are you taking?
Klonopin, Seroquel, and Clomiphene.
Get arrested down in this area for
misdemeanor. So that's how you took them? Took them today? How was it last time?
Yesterday.
Yesterday.
Asshole!
Shh.
Fucking coward. Whole bunch of people on your side, just no me here, fucker. Sit down. Won't you ask nicely, you fucker?
Fucking tell me.
You got smart with me first, you asshole. And then now he got smart, so I have the right. Slam his fucking head on the concrete. Busted my freaking forehead. Asshole. Jail's fucked up, even in democracy, isn't it? There's no justice here. Whatever you think is right, I got no say in it.
You stabbing the forehead?
No.
That's wrong. Fucking coward. You hit me first, okay? You saw it, it's on camera. Oh, you don't care, it doesn't matter. It's an officer against fucking with a suspicious person.
Does he want me to stomp this? Keep running?
What asshole, fucking coward. Probably the reason why he got this job in the first place. Get the rough for some people because my wife's bad at me.
Sir, what's your last name?
Officer.
Sir, what's your last name?
Pham.
What was it?
Pham.
P-H-A-M, right?
Yes.
Sorry, what? P-H-A-M.
That is my forehead.
Think anyone will get stitches.
I'm in handcuffs. He's got a gun. He's bigger than me. Yeah, I'm a threat.
I wasn't out there. I don't know what happened.
Wow, yeah, you know that. You are young. Coward. Like, doesn't mean, where am I going? I'm like, I'm not going anywhere. Coward! Fucking coward! I'm in handcuffs. I'm smaller than you. You got a gun and 10, 12 other people behind you. Fucking coward. You're a fucking coward! Handcuffed. And you really had to slam my head on the concrete to arrest me, right? Put me in handcuffs. You did it because you wanted to. You have hatred towards me. For that moment, you think for some reason that I spoke up for myself. Fucking coward. I could die today, but you know what? You're still gonna be a coward for the rest of your life. Hiding behind your uniform. You didn't have to break my face. You didn't have to break my face. You're a coward. You're gonna be a coward.
Coward. Did you come through here to patch you down?
Oh, I gotta go get some in, I guess. I'm a real threat. I'm a real threat in my chain here. Man with a gun and a badge. I'm a real threat. You had to protect yourself, right? By slamming my face on the concrete. Yeah, I'm a big threat, all right. Look at me.
This is for his transfer. I don't know if you're a target or someone. You want to see if the line else he's in there? He just seems to be trying to get a red card.
Yeah, Menick's on his way to go get a sedan. No, I'm still taping.
All right, do we have a zip phone?
I don't have who was on it either.
Sergeant Morse, P number 5388. This is inmate Tam, T-H-A-M, first name.
P-H-A-M.
P-H, my bad, it's written horribly by our medical staff. P-H-A-M. First name is K-H-O-Y, is that right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Don't have an ID number on him yet. Was sitting in the pre-arrest area. We had a gentleman sitting next to him that was spitting on the floor. We stood him up and removed him from the area, at which time Mr. Pham stood up. Was told to sit back down by Burnt. He did not sit back down. Burnt pushed him back into the chair, in which he kicked Burnt with his leg. Burnt then grabbed him by his left arm, started trying to stand him up, put him in a wrist lock. Pham resisted a little bit, would not stand up, started trying to pull away, leaning his body. Do you know who it was that came over to assist you? Officer Sui and Leongson also came over when they were able to get him out of the chair. When they finally got him up, he kind of flew really fast into the corner, hit his head on the floor, right in the corner by the wall. It split his left eye open. I was only able to catch part of it. I was transporting the other inmate to the Z3. Sustained an injury, had medical staff come look at him. NP Ralph Aquino looked at him, decided they needed to go out to the hospital, have it checked out for possible sutures. This time we're waiting for Officer Menick to transport him to UMC. He's going to go ahead and be booked since the incident occurred at CCDC with COs. He'll be booked and we'll be doing the transport. Injuries? At this time, no known injuries to officers. End of briefing.
On camera, Laverne 7143.